Hello children, welcome back to Learning Online with Ronita. So today we are going to start a new chapter from your Living English workbook for class 2. Okay, so here the chapter is chapter number 3, Appu and the Carrot. It is a comprehension passage that we have been given and we have to read it and solve the questions. I've already solved the questions, I just wanted to go through this to see how to solve such comprehension passages. Okay, let's start. Read the story. Once a beautiful fish lived in a large ocean. His scales shone like the colors of a rainbow. You know what are scales? Fish scales, I suppose. Yes. So these scales of the fish, you know, it was shining like the colors of a rainbow. His name was Rainbow Fish. Okay. So what was his name? His name was Rainbow Fish. All right. Very nice. Come and play with us, Rainbow Fish, they said. One day, a little pink fish said, Rainbow Fish, please give me some of your scales. They are so beautiful and you have so many. Go away, said Rainbow Fish. They are mine. So now what happened? So this fish's name was Rainbow Fish. Now one day, everyone used to tell him that come and play with us, Rainbow Fish, and they all used to play together. One day, one little pink fish came to the Rainbow Fish and asked him for some of the scales, okay? Because they looked very beautiful and he had many scales, okay? So now what happened? Now the Rainbow Fish is saying, go away. I can't give you anything. They are mine. The little pink fish swam away. He told his friends what Rainbow Fish had said. So now the pink fish was also very sad and hurt. So he went and he told it to his friends. Now nobody played with Rainbow Fish. He became very lonely. He went to his friend Ollie Octopus. What should I do, Ollie? Rainbow Fish asked. Ollie Octopus said, give every fish one of your shining scales. Then you may not be the most beautiful fish in the ocean, but it will make you happy. Rainbow Fish began to give his scales away soon. Now what happened? Now we could see that he was giving away his scales. Okay, now listen to the next part. Soon he was surrounded by many small fish. Now since he decided to distribute his scales as instructed by his friend Ollie the octopus, so now he has been surrounded by lots and lots of small fishes. He got many friends. He gave a shining scale to each one. There came a time when he had only one scale left, but he was very happy. So he was distributing every scale that he had. And you know, there was a time when he did not have any scale at all, but he was very happy. Come on, Rainbow Fish, come and play with us, called the others. Rainbow Fish played happily with the other fish. He was no longer lonely and sad. So what do we learn from here, children? We learn that we should always share our things with our friends. Then only we get happiness, isn't it? Yes. So now let's solve the true and false part. See, write true and false. It is given, the tail of the rainbow fish was colorful like a rainbow. Is it the trail which was like that? No, it was the body, the scales. So it is false. Rainbow fish did not like to play with other fish. No, it is false. The little pink fish asked Rainbow Fish for one of his scales. True. Rainbow Fish was lonely because no one played with him. True. Ollie Octopus asked Rainbow Fish not to share his scales. No, that is false. Circle the correct answer. We learn from the story that we should share or not share what we have with others. We should definitely share. So I have circled share. You also circle share. Okay. Now the next one. Read these words aloud. Lie, tie, pie, fried, cried, loud, cloud, found, sound, and round. So these are some of the words which end with IE and it has OU in it. Okay. So what are they? The words with IE, which have IE in them, are lie, tie, pie, fried, cried. And the words which have OU in them are loud, cloud, found, sound, and round. Clear? So this is some of the words that we learned today which had IE or OU in them. Alright, so children, I hope you understood the chapter and you have understood how we have solved the true and false. Now let us move on to the next page and see what's there. So the next page. Circle 5 OU words in the word search. Write them on the blank. So I have found out some words. Let me show you. See, the first one is already done for you, found. The next one is ground, G-R-O-U-N-D, ground. Next is H-O-U-S-E, house. Next is cloud, C-L-O-U-D. See, there we can get another word. What is it? L-O-U-D, loud. So, see, you know, this is another thing that we learned. So, from the word cloud, we also get the word loud. So, this is how we can make such words. From one word, we get another word. Isn't it? Interesting, right? Yes. Now, let's move on to the next one. Write these words in the correct columns. So, there are some names given, names of fruits and vegetables. Okay, it's given in both the sides of the boxes and we have to fill it with in the correct place. So fruits, first one is done, papaya, correct. Next, which fruit do we need to write? Mango, orange, cherry. Vegetables, peas, carrot, onion, beans. Clear? Children, papaya we eat as a vegetable, but it is actually a fruit. Okay, we also can eat it as a fruit. Alright, just like tomato. It is not a vegetable, it's a fruit. Now let's move on to next one. Fill in the blanks with words from the box. So in the box we have got some words like feather, bee, owl, cherry, lion. So we have to fill in the blanks with these words. Let's see the first one. It's already done. As brave as a lion. Yes, a lion is very brave. So we can be as brave as a lion. Yes, as busy as a bee. So a bee is always busy, you know, buzzing around every time. So a person who is very busy can act like a bee, isn't it? The next one. As wise as an owl. Yes, owls are known to be very wise and intelligent. So if we have to be intelligent, then we must behave like an owl. So as wise as an owl. Clear? So children, this part is clear, I suppose. Here what did we do? Here we had found some OU words, words which had OU in it, and then we had written it down in the box. Then we had placed the names of the fruits and vegetables in the correct columns. Also, we have learned about some important phrases that we use in English language, isn't it? Now let us move on to the next page and see this. Okay, so next page is the continuation of the previous page. Here it is given as light as a feather and as red as a cherry. Okay, so these are, feather is the lightest thing that we have seen till date, and cherry is the most beautiful fruit with very nice red color. You know, no other fruit is as red as cherry. So therefore, we have used these words. These are phrases that we use in our daily life. Okay, now let us move on to the next one. Fill in the blanks with is or are. This is very easy. We can do it. Let's do it. First one is already done. The birds are flying. Correct. So we know that whenever there is a plural number, we use are with it. And in singular number, we use is with it. Okay. So the birds are flying. The farmers are in the field. Why are? Because there is an S with farmer. So farmers are in the field. Mr. Patel is only one, singular, so it would be is driving a tractor. Zeba is only one person, it's singular number, so we are writing is watering the plants. Clear? Now the next one. Replace is with was and are with were and rewrite these sentences. Children, first of all, I would like to say that we don't say where. W-E-R-E, many people say where, but it's not where, it's were. So I will be saying that only. I hope you will understand. So children, in the first sentence, I found out there is a mistake in the sentence. Jaya is skating in the skating ring. It's written K, rink. It would be ring, G. Okay. So change that and then write the answer. So is given, we have to write was. So Jaya was skating in the skating ring. Was and were, these are past tense. Okay. Something which has already happened. There aren't many apples in the basket. There were many apples in the basket. The children are enjoying the rain. The children were enjoying the rain. The swan is swimming in the lake. The swan was swimming in the lake. So whenever we use is, okay, if we have to use it in past tense is something that has already happened. Then we have to write was in place of is, and we have to write where or were in case of are. Okay, so this is how we change the simple tense. Simple tense means something that is happening right now. Simple present tense, something that is happening right now. We have to change it into the past tense. Okay, now the next page. Look at the picture and complete the sentence with the words from the box. Okay, so here I've made some mistake, you know, while seeing the picture, but I have corrected it. I hope you will understand that. See, Soha and her family went for a picnic. Yes, we can see that they went to a park. Yes, absolutely, they were in a park. Soha played with a ball. So this I had mistaken with this picture. So it is a ball. Her sister Mona played with a top. Mother had packed many nice things to eat. Their pet dog was also with them. Everyone had great fun. So this is picture composition. You will, you know, see whenever you see such things, you know, you have to see the picture and write the fill in the blanks with the complete paragraph, then that is a picture composition. We have to see the picture and write the composition. Okay, so children, I hope you've understood this chapter and also you have understood how to solve this workbook. So since it is a workbook, I had already told you before, we all have to do it in the book itself. It won't be done in any other copy. So whenever you solve a workbook, you need to do it in the workbook given to you itself. Clear? So children, that's it for today. And I hope there is no confusion. If there is any confusion, you can get in touch with me through the comment section. We will meet again soon. Till then, take care. Bye-bye and lots of love. Bye.